This is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be trying out Sister Mary in my Nuns with Guns deck. And I will be playing the Return to the Dunwich Legacy campaign scenario 1B. So I still haven't decided if I'm going to continue this as a campaign series, but at least I'm testing out the deck right after the new Taboo changes. So the big change in this deck concerning the Taboo list is that the 35 caliber Winchester now triggers also with blessed tokens, because if I pull a blessed token that is considered as a non-negative modifier blessed token, so the new version of the Winchester will trigger off from that and deal +2 damage. So what the better way to test that out than to try out Sister Mary? The Winchester also works with Jim Culver's skull ability, so when Jim pulls a skull, it's a zero, so the Winchester just became even better in the Winchester Jim build I have demonstrated earlier. We are playing the House Always Wins scenario from the Return to Dunwich Legacy campaign this time. At the setup we will add 2 blessed tokens to the back with Sister Mary's ability. I am playing on standard, so other tokens that can trigger off from the Winchester are 2 zeros and 1+1 token, and also the Elder Sign. So I'm hoping we can get a bunch of blessed tokens into the back and start firing up some enemies with the Winchester. But let's see Sister Mary's deck before we start. I also added 2 45 automatics into the deck to add to the weapons available to deal with enemies. To fetch the right weapon, I've added 2 prepared for the worsts. Then there are a lot of different events. I actually had to change one of the second winds into the Hallowed Mirror, so that I also have some assets to play. But there are the staple clue getting events like Drawn to the Flame, and because Sister Mary is now made into a fighting Sister Mary, there is evidence. Also Scene of the Crime. Then of course, just to have a way to investigate without the events, I have 2 sixth senses in the deck. Also Rite of Sanctification x2, so that we can get some discounts to the events and to the assets that we are playing. In the ally slots, I have David Renfield, a staple in every deck that can run Mystic cards, and also Olive McBride, that is a really key piece to the successful firing off of the Winchester. I haven't picked the basic weakness yet, so we'll do that next. So that is enough of the deck. I have all the campaign and other basic weaknesses in this deck. I've only removed the multiplayer only weaknesses from this deck. So we'll shuffle it up and see which weakness Sister Mary will get. And we'll just pick one from the middle somewhere. Well, I think this feels good. Okay, well, we got the tower. Well, that is a bummer. I really hate that weakness. So we'll just change the sleeve, and we'll have to live with the tower in the deck. But I think that is not the worst we could have gotten. I think because this deck is really resource reliant, I'm happy I didn't hit the indebted or any of the doomed or the offer I can't refuse weaknesses, because those are just annoying. At least with the tower you can play around it or deal with it if you happen to draw it into your opening hand or something like that. Okay, so the weakness is there, and we are starting at La Bella Luna and we'll go from there, but that is enough of the Deccan scenario, so let's get started. We are ready to draw our opening hand. I'm hoping to get the Winchester out early so I don't have to worry about it anymore. So we get the Scene of the Crime, Sixth Sense, Rite of Sanctification, we'll redraw the Crisis of Faith. We get Olive McBride, really useful, and the 45 automatic. So I think I want... I'll... Okay, so... I think I'll use the Scene of the Crime, mulligan it, and we'll get prepared for the worst. So I think we'll search for the Winchester with the prepare for the worst and keep the 45 automatic as a backup. Okay, first action. I tried to... first action we'll play Olive McBride. Actually, let's back up a bit. I think I'll play the Rite of Sanctification. And we have two Bless tokens in the back, so I'll seal them onto the Rite of Sanctification. Just search for them. The rest back into the bag. So these are sealed here. Second action. We'll play the Sixth Sense. And it's two cheaper, and we'll return one less token back into the bag. And last action, we'll investigate here. And I will be using the Sixth Sense. So I'm investigating 4 versus 2. We're just trying to get this clue before the pit boss comes. Nosing around here. And it's a -1. We grab this clue. That is our investigation phase. Enemy phase. This pit boss hunts here. But it's aloof because of the agenda 1A. And we ready up. We draw a card. I get to take the initiative. And I'll gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We added doomed to the agenda, and counter card is a swarm of rats. Okay, so we need to defeat those rats and continue. So first action, I'll just punch the rats. I'm hitting 3 versus 2. I don't feel like committing any cards to this test. Yeah, let's just hit. And it's a 0, so the rats are defeated. Second action, let's play the prepare for the worst. I will spend the resource and not use the... Oh yeah, we should have added 1 blessed token to the back at the end of the last round, which is the Marisa ability. I'm always forgetting that, and I should remember because that's the whole point of playing system errors. We're not testing anything. We're playing the prepared for the worst. So we get 9 cards. I'm hoping to find the Winchester. So we actually didn't find any weapon, which is a shame. Oh well, sometimes you just fail with that card, and it is what it is. And last action, we'll just move into the Clover Club Lounge. So, it's the new one, so it is the one that forced after Clover Club Lounge is revealed, put the set aside Clover Club stage into play. While it is at 1, Clover Club Lounge gains action, look at the top card of your deck. If it is an ally asset, you may put it into play, otherwise draw it. Okay. Limit once per round. And that is my turn. The enemy phase is basically this guy hunts here and just follows us. We'll gain 1 card. Damn it. Okay, and we gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is another swarm of rats. I'll have to check. Did I shuffle this? Yeah, it's shuffled. But I just got really unlucky with the... Well, unlucky and unlucky. The rats are easy to defeat, but still they cost me actions which I need to set up and stuff like that. So just shuffle this because I have to check. So the rats come engage with us. First action, we'll just punch the rats again to get rid of them. 3 versus 1. It's an auto fail, so we could cheat, but I think I don't need to cheat at this point. So we'll just try to punch again. And it's a -1, so the rats are defeated. And last action. I'll use this discount here. So this gets discarded, and okay, yeah. Again, forgot to put the best token into the back at the end of the round. So we'll get the Olive McBride in play. Okay, now I'll add 1 at the end of the round. 1 blessed token, I mean. The big boss doesn't hunt anywhere, so we'll just ready up and draw a card. And we get the evidence and we gain resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Encounter card for this turn is... Oh yeah, we add 1 doom. So we are at 3 of 4 doom. We get a mobster. It just spawns here, but it is still aloof. So I'll just put it over here and mark it here. Okay, so first action. Oh yeah, we should have this in play also. Totally forgot about that. So I think we'll go to the Clover Club bar. And I think I'll have a drink. So second action, we'll have a drink. I'll mark that with just this, so we gain 1 clue. And oh yeah, I'll just rearrange these a bit. I think I'm drawing a card as the last action. So I draw a card, we get another prepared for the worst, and I think I'll try to find the Winchester next turn again. Okay, that is that turn. This hunt's here. We draw a card, we get the deny of existence, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So the agenda one advances. Okay, so on the right track. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. If the players have completed extracurricular activity, advance directly to agenda 2B. Well, we haven't, so we just shuffle these rats back into the deck. And nothing else happens. Except underground muscle. So now the big boss is not aloof anymore, which is a problem, but I think we are evading the big boss this turn and moving to the card room. Oh yeah, actually these are also connected. We could go to the cover club stage also. So big boss engages us. So the encounter card is Cursed Luck. We put Cursed Luck into play. Well, first action will evade and I will commit. Take the initiative. So it gives us plus 3 agility. We are evading 6 versus 3. And we have Cursed Luck, so we get a minus 1, so 5 versus 3. We get a Blessed Token. So I think if we don't, we get a minus 3, but we have, it's basically a minus 1. We remove that. So we succeed. This gets discarded. And this is evaded, and because we draw this, we get 3 resources. So we are pretty set with resources. At the moment, I'm actually changing this to a 5 resource marker. Okay, so the pit boss is evaded. I'll search for a weapon now. If we find the Winchester, I play it, and next turn I can just shoot the pit boss. So let's see 9 cards. And we get the Winchester. It was the topmost card, so okay. We also saw a weakness, but we can just shuffle the deck back. And last action, we'll play the Winchester. So I'll put it here because it takes up 2 hand slots. Actually, it's annoying me. I'll just put it over there. It has 5 ammo on it. And that is our round. No enemy actions. We go to upkeep. The big boss readies. We draw a card. We get the premonition and we gain 1 resource. Okay. And we add 1 blessed token into the bag. So we have 5 blessed tokens in the bag, so hopefully we can hit one when we shoot the big boss next turn. But that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. And counter card is cursed luck. Well, that is okay, I think. So first action, we'll just shoot the pit boss. I'm using the Winchester. I'm using Olive. So we are fighting 5 minus 1, so 4 versus 3. Do I have any icons to commit? No. So we grab 3 and choose 2. So we get a blessed token. I'll get a new token. Another blessed token. Okay, back, we get it. And a -1, so we'll pick these and cancel that. So the skill value is -2, but basically this negates it, so we're shooting at 4, 6 versus 3, so we definitely hit. We hit enough to get rid of the bad luck. We'll remove these, add these back, and the Winchester deals +2 damage, so we deal 3 damage to the pit boss. And I'll actually premonition the next token, so we see if we need to even use the Winchester. Okay, so it's a -4. Ouch. So I think I'm just punching without using anything, so we miss. And last action, we'll actually use the Winchester to shoot. And we basically just need to hit, so I'm shooting 5 versus 3. So we get the blessed token. Okay. And a -1. So we hit. And pit boss is defeated. So it goes into the victory display. And that is our turn. We add 1 blessed token in the back at the end of the round. Unluckily, there's no clues to be picked up with the evidence, but it is what it is. We are ready up, we draw a card, get take the initiative, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. The encounter card is rats. Of course it is. Okay, so we're just punching the rats again. So 3 versus 1, bless 5 versus 1, and an elder sign. So we'll add 1 bless token into the bag, and the rats are defeated. Next action, we'll move into the. Let's go to the card room. So we'll use the action to spend 2 resources. We'll use Olive. So we are trying to find. So we spend 2 resources, reveal a random chaos token. If it is an elder sign token, gain 2 clues and two resources from the token pool. If it's an even number, gain two clues from the token pool. If it's an odd number, nothing happens. So you're basically just trying to find some clues here. We need two clues to get the agenda, the act advance. So let's draw three. And we get an even. We'll pick these two. So we get an even number. So we get two clues. And we have to immediately use them. So we advance the act. So, high roller. Put the set aside dark and tall into play. It is not agenda 1A, so we skip the put a criminal there part. So, next skin game. Only investigators in the VIP area may spend the required number of clues group to advance, and it's two. So, that is that. Enemy base, nothing happens. Upkeep, we get a resource and draw a card. We get another evidence. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. The agenda advances. We have to get a move on. There is only one agenda after that. So, oh yeah, after the last round, we forgot to add a blessed token to the back. Just adding that before we do anything else. So, sudden chaos. Spawn a random enemy from the set aside hideous abominations and counter set into the Clover Club lounge. We do that so we have these. Shuffle them up. Okay. So we get the conglomeration of spears and these get shuffled into the encounter deck along with the discard pile. So Abella Luna gets removed and this spawns here. Okay, and then we have chaos in the Clover Club. So, paused at the start of the enemy phase, discard each criminal enemy in the same location as an abomination enemy. So, that mobster is definitely gonna be eaten up. We get an encounter card, and it is a mobster. So, it spawns on us. And nothing special. So I think the first action will be to... I think I'll take one attack of opportunity. Because I really want to defeat the mobster in the darkened hall if there's a possibility to get clues. So first action, we'll take one attack of opportunity, move to the darkened hall, and there are no clues here, and we'll spawn the set aside back hall doorway, shrines 3, we shuffle them up. Okay, so I put them like this. Then I'll take another attack of opportunity and move into one of these, so I'll just start from here. we get the art gallery. It's a two-shot location with one clue post. After you fail a skill test while investigating the art gallery, lose two resources. Last action, I will use the Winchester to fire at the mobster. I'll use Olive. Olive should be unexhausted, so I'll exhaust Olive. Picking three. Okay, we get a blessed and a zero. We get another for the blessed. And it's a minus one, so we'll pick the blessed and the zero. So we deal three damage to the mobster, defeating the mobster. And also we'll spend one resource to play the evidence. So we'll grab this clue up while we're at it. And I think that is our turn, so we ready up. Enemy phase before that, so this mobster is defeated at the start of the enemy phase. And this agglomeration of spears moves here. And then we will ready. We draw a card, we get evidence, scene of the crime, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, the encounter card is agglomeration of spheres. So this isn't a good spot to have this engaged with us. So first action, we will evade it. We are evading 6 versus 4. Oh yeah, we forgot to add one bless token at the end of the last round. We add it now. And I am using Olive for this test because we really need to evade this. Yeah. And we pick the 2 minus 1s, so this spear is evaded, and then second action will move to the darkened hall, last action will move over here, so we find the VIP area. And there's one clue there, and that is our turn. This agglomeration of spears hunts here. We get a card, we get Ward of Protection, we gain one resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, the encounter card is Obanion Tuck. So it spawns engage with us. We are really getting all of the enemies. Well, yeah, always forget to ready Olive. So first action will just play scene of the crime. It doesn't trigger attacks of opportunity. We get a clue. We can spend the clues. So we Dr. Morgan's Fate. If the players have not completed, so put the set aside Dr. Morgan in the play in the VIP area. Advance to Act 3A all in. So we get Francis Morgan in play here. I'll mark him with these. And we are in Act 3A all in. So, while Dr. Morgan is not controlled by a player, he gains Action parlay test will power 3 to shake Dr. Morgan out of his daze. If you succeed, place one clue on from the token bank on him. If there are one clues per investigator on Dr. Morgan, take control of him. Objective, if each undefeated investigator has resigned, advance. Okay, and second action. We will use the Winchester to fire at the mobster. I'll use Olive McBride. And we are shooting 5 versus 4. Should we evade this guy? I think it's more easy to evade it. So let's cancel the shot. We are evading 3 versus 2. I'll go to 4 versus 2. And actually 5 versus 2. We still use Olive. No, let's save Olive for the willpower check. Okay, so a bit of a risk evading 5 versus 2. I cannot gain resource. Oh yeah. Last upkeep. Yeah, we wouldn't have drawn this or gained one resource. Yeah, I usually miss that, so I'll just shuffle this back into the deck. So we didn't get the card and we didn't gain a resource. So I'm evading 4 versus 2. Okay, it's a minus 2 because it's a skull, so we succeed. We could use resources to make it a 0, but we don't need to. So this guy is evaded. Last action, I will use Olive to make the willpower check of 3 versus 4 versus 3, I'll go to 5 versus 3. So 5 versus 3, and we are using Olive. Okay, so we get a blessed token. And minus 2, so we'll pick these and the plus 1. So we definitely succeed in the test, so we get gain. Francis Morgan. And Olive is discarded. Or let's see. Yeah, because Dr. Francis Morgan takes up an ally slot, so we'll put him into play. And yeah, let's see. Yeah, now we need to get out of here. That is the investigation phase, enemy phase. This sphere. Let's just remove these. So we take 1 damage from here and 1 horror. And I'll take the damage on Francis Morgan and the horror on to myself. That is the enemy phase. Oh yeah. This one readies. Readied last turn and moves here. Yeah. And yeah, that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get a premonition. And we gain 1 resource. Oh yeah, and again, I messed this up. We don't draw cards or gain resources here, so I'll shuffle this back. So easy to forget. Okay, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Yeah, this Redis, by the way, is engaged with us. Now we go to the next job. Okay, we add a Doom to the agenda, encounter card is. We get the Servant of the Lurker. Okay, we are really getting every enemy possible. Well, this is such bad. This is such a bad situation. Okay, well, is there any way to get out of this situation? I think we need to evade to and move and try to get to the back doorway next turn. Yeah. So, first action will evade the Servant of the Lurker. Oh yeah, we add one bless at the end of the last round. Actually, first action will try to shoot with the Winchester, killing the Albanian thug. Okay, there are five bless tokens, so I'm hoping we grab one of at least one of those. So I'm fighting five versus two, four. Okay. Okay, so we managed to kill off this enemy. That helps a lot. And second action, we'll try to evade the Servant of the Lurker. I'm evading 3 versus 2. Okay, Skull. In Skull is a minus 2, but I'll spend the 2 sources to treat it as a 0. So that guy is evaded. Last action, we'll move here. I'll take 1 damage and 1 horror. And that is that turn. So this is here. Enemy phase. Okay, this guy engages us. Let's see. I'll take 1 damage and 1 horror. 1 damage and 1 horror. And that is that. We'll go to upkeep, we draw a card. 6 cents doesn't help us, and we gain 1 resource. Okay, change this back to here. Okay, we have plenty of resources, but we need to survive to the next round. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We again forgot to add 1 less token in the back. Okay, we have this 2 agglomeration of spears on us, so we just need to resign. We add a Doom to the agenda. Encounter card is, oh yeah, this is readied. Encounter card is something in the drinks. Search each player who has had a drink loses 1 action. We lose 1 action. And Twist of Fate. Reveal a random token from the chaos pack if you reveal a elder sign symbol or positive number, nothing happens. If you reveal any other number, take 1 damage. If you reveal skull, cultist, tablet, or auto fail, or any of the special symbols, you take 2 horror. Well, the 2 horror is actually the best we get, so I'm hoping we hit that, but let's see. Okay, We get a zero, so nothing happens, luckily. We lose one action though, so first action we'll move it to the back alley. There's one clue here, and we'll take attacks of opportunity. We'll cancel one of the damage, so we'll take one damage and two horror. And last action will resign. Okay, well, we managed to get out of here alive with Dr. Francis Morgan under our control. So let's see. So we get resolution 2. In your campaign log, record that the Obanion gang has a bone to pick with the investigators. In your campaign log, record that the investigator rescued Dr. Francis Morgan. Any one investigator may choose to add Dr. Francis Morgan to his or her deck. This card does not count towards the investigator's deck size. And I will definitely be adding Dr. Francis Morgan into this deck because he brings so much damage soak. So that is really helpful. If any player cheated, well, I didn't, so I don't add the Elder Thing token into the back. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. We got these locations and the pit boss, so we get 3 experience. There is a clue on the back alley, so one mention. If I would have gotten this clue and resigned, I just dropped the clue there. So if it's a pointless exercise. The only way to get that location is that if I were playing multiplayer, one of the players would grab that clue, move up to another location and get defeated and drop the clue there. So yeah, it is what it is. I won't go into more detail about that. So I proceed to scenario 1A, extracurricular activity. So I'm actually liking this deck so much that I think I will continue playing this. I may record the playthroughs, but not sure at the moment. But still, this was the Winchester Mary deck, and it works pretty well. I think there is enough to get clues and plenty of power to defeat enemies with the Winchester weapon. You only need to find it, but of course there's the backups. But yeah, let me know in the comments what you think about this deck and about the changes that were made into it with Taboo changes. So thanks for watching, and until next time.